GST from past two classes. Today also we will continue to learn the GST third chapter, that is the charge of GST. So manam last class lo discuss chestunnattu section 9 subsection 3 lo em chepparante reverse charge mechanism gurinchi chepparu. So the government may, on the recommendations of the council, by notification specify categories of supply of goods or services or both, the tax on which shall be paid on reverse charge basis by the recipient of such goods or service or both, and all the provisions of the act shall apply to such recipient as if he is the person liable for paying the tax in relation to such supply of goods or services or both. So section 9 subsection 3 em cheptundante గవర్నమెంట్ జిఎస్టీ కౌన్సిల్ యొక్క రికమెండేషన్స్తో నోటిఫికేషన్ ప్రిపేర్ చేసింది. ఏమని, స్పెసిఫిక్ కేటగిరీ ఆఫ్ సప్లై ఆఫ్ గూడ్స్ ఆర్ సర్వీసెస్ ఆర్ బోత్ చేసే వాళ్ళకి ఏమవుతుందంటే, ఆ టైంలో ఆ పర్టికులర్ సప్లైస్కి దేర్ విల్ బి రెసిపియంట్ అండ్ దేర్ విల్ బి సప్లయర్. సో ఇన్స్టెడ్ ఆఫ్ ద సప్లయర్ పేయింగ్ ద ట్యాక్స్ టు ద గవర్నమెంట్, ద రెసిపియంట్ షుడ్ పే ద ట్యాక్స్ టు ద గవర్నమెంట్. ట్యాక్స్ లయబిలిటీ అనేది రెసిపియంట్ మీద పడుతుంది. ఓకే, సో దీన్ని బెటర్ అండర్స్టాండ్ చేసుకోవడం కోసం పిక్టోరియల్గా తెలుసుకుందాం. సి, నార్మల్ మెకానిజం ఆఫ్ లెవీ ఆఫ్ జిఎస్టీ. రిసీవియర్ సప్లయర్కి మేక్స్ పేమెంట్ ప్లస్ జిఎస్టీ, అంటే గూడ్స్ యొక్క వాల్యూతో పాటు జిఎస్టీని కూడా సప్లయర్కి పే చేస్తాడు. తర్వాత సప్లయర్ రిసీవ్ చేసుకున్న జిఎస్టీ అమౌంట్ని అతను గవర్నమెంట్కి డిపాజిట్ చేస్తాడు. ఇది నార్మల్ మెకానిజం. బట్ రివర్స్ ఛార్జ్ మెకానిజం ఎలా అవుతుందంటే, రివర్స్ రిసీవర్ సప్లయర్కి ఓన్లీ గూడ్ యొక్క వాల్యూ సంబంధించిన పేమెంట్ మాత్రమే చేస్తాడు, బట్ జిఎస్టీ మాత్రం పే చేయడు. రివర్స్ ఛార్జ్ మెకానిజంలో రిసీవర్ ఓన్లీ విల్ బీ పేయింగ్ ద ట్యాక్స్ టు ద గవర్నమెంట్, దట్ ఈస్ జిఎస్టీ. రిసీవరే జిఎస్టీని అమౌంట్ని డిపాజిట్ చేస్తాడు గవర్నమెంట్కి ఆన్ బిహాఫ్ ఆఫ్ సప్లయర్. ఓకే, సో ఇది రివర్స్ ఛార్జ్ మెకానిజం. సో రివర్స్ ఛార్జ్ మెకానిజంని అర్థం చేసుకోవడానికి సింపుల్గా ఏం చెప్పచ్చు అంటే, రివర్స్ ఛార్జ్ మెకానిజం ఈజ్ ఎ మెకానిజం అండర్ విచ్ ద రెసిపియంట్ ఆఫ్ ద గూడ్స్ ఆర్ సర్వీసెస్ ఈజ్ లయబుల్ టు పే ద ట్యాక్స్ ఇన్స్టెడ్ ఆఫ్ ద ప్రొవైడర్ ఆఫ్ ద గూడ్స్ అండ్ సర్వీసెస్. Here, the liability to pay tax shift from supplier to recipient under reverse charge mechanism. So, reverse charge mechanism ante idi. But, manaku section 9 subsection 3 lo specific supply of goods or services are both annadu. So, anni goods or services or both supplies meeda ee reverse charge mechanism anedi apply kaadu. So, aa konni services e ఏంటో మనము తెలుసుకుందాం. సో హియర్ వి ఆర్ ఇంటు ద పేజ్ నంబర్ 3.13 చాప్టర్ ఛార్జ్ ఆఫ్ జిఎస్టీ. మనకు ఆర్సీఎం మీద అప్లికేబుల్ అయ్యే స్పెసిఫిక్ సప్లైస్ ఆఫ్ గూడ్స్, స్పెసిఫిక్ సప్లై ఆఫ్ సర్వీసెస్ గురించి మెన్షన్ చేశారు. స్పెసిఫిక్ సప్లైస్ ఆఫ్ గూడ్స్ ఏంటిదో తెలుసుకుందాం. సప్లైస్ ఆఫ్ గూడ్స్ ట్యాక్సబుల్ అండర్ రివర్స్ ఛార్జ్, దట్ ఈస్ ద గూడ్స్ వేర్ ట్యాక్స్ ఈస్ పేయబుల్ బై ద రిసిపియంట్. గూడ్స్ లైక్ క్యాష్యూ నట్స్, బీడీ వ్రాపర్ లీవ్స్, టొబాకో లీవ్స్, సప్లై ఆఫ్ లాటరీ, సిల్కియాన్, యూజ్డ్ వెహికల్స్, సీజ్డ్ అండ్ కన్ఫిస్కేటెడ్ గూడ్స్, ఓల్డ్ అండ్ యూజ్డ్ గూడ్స్, వేస్ట్ అండ్ స్క్రాప్ అండ్ రా కాటన్ ఎక్సెట్రా ఆర్ ట్యాక్సబుల్ అండర్ రివర్స్ ఛార్జ్. సో ఈ ఓన్లీ ఈ గూడ్స్కి సంబంధించి మాత్రమే రివర్స్ ఛార్జ్ మెకానిజం అనేది అప్లై అవుతుంది. దట్ మీన్స్ హియర్ వెన్ దెర్ ఈస్ అ సప్లై ఆఫ్ దీస్ టైప్ ఆఫ్ గూడ్స్, ద సప్లయర్ విల్ నాట్ పే ద ట్యాక్స్ టు ద గవర్నమెంట్. ఐ మీన్ సప్లయర్ విల్ నాట్ డిపాజిట్ ద జిఎస్టీ అమౌంట్ టు ద గవర్నమెంట్, బట్ ద రెసిపియంట్ హూ ఈస్ రిసీవింగ్ దీస్ టైప్ ఆఫ్ గూడ్స్, that recipient will be paying the GST, that is he will deposit the GST amount to the government. Okay, next, coming to the supply of services taxable under reverse charge under Section 9, Subsection 3 of CGST Act, that is the services where tax is payable by the recipient. Now let us get into the topic of specific supply of services which are taxable under reverse charge mechanism. There are 14 points like this. In that, first one, supply of goods by a goods transport agency in respect of transportation of goods by road. So firstly, we should know what is goods transport agency. Goods transport agency, any person who provides service in relation to transport of goods by road and issues consignment note by whatever name called, that is called goods transport agency. Simply we can say that if any person or any business entity hires a vehicle, transport vehicle, and they have to hire the transport vehicle to transport the goods from one place to another place. If in this case, if the transporter, who is the vehicle owner, after transporting the goods from one place to another place, if he issues a consignment note, that is simply we can say a document which is showing the details of the goods which are transported, from where it is transported, and who will be paying the GST, like that, is that recipient paying the GST or the transport supplier who is paying the GST, like that, certain details will be mentioned in the consignment note. If in this case the transporter who is transporting the goods from one place to another place is issuing a consignment note, then that type of transportation is to be included in GTA. Whoever you take as transporter of goods from one place to another place, if he provides a consignment note at the time of delivery of goods from one place to another place, then he should be treated as goods transport agency. Now we have to check in this case of reverse charge mechanism to whom the services are provided, because in reverse charge mechanism the supplier is not important, the recipient is important, because the supplier will not be liable to deposit the GST amount to the government. The recipient is liable to deposit the GST amount to the government. So we shall be concentrating on the recipient of the service. Okay. Now, in the first point, they have said about supply of services by a goods transport agency in respect of transportation goods by road too. This is mentioning only by road, okay, that too for specific purposes. So we have to check for whom the GTA services are provided. 2. A. Any factory registered under or governed by Factories Act 1948. Okay, any factory registered under Factories Act, any society registered under Societies Registration Act, okay, any cooperative society established by or under any law, any person registered under the CGST Act or the IGST Act or the SGST Act or the UTGST Act, that is registered person under GST, any body corporate established by or under any law, or any partnership firm whether registered or not under any law including association of persons, any casual taxable person. So GTA services provided by any person to these specific category of persons, then reverse charge mechanism will be applicable, so that the specific persons what we have read before, that specific persons receiving the service, GTA services, should be depositing the GST amount to the government. So these are the recipients who factory registered under the Factories Act, society registered under Societies Registration Act, any cooperative society, any person registered under GST, or any body corporate partnership firm, whether registered or not, including AOP, Association of Persons, any casual taxable persons. These are to be the persons who are receiving the GTA services and should deposit the GST amount to the government. And the supplier of the service, goods transport agency, who has not paid CGST at 6%. This one we will be discussing after this whole table. Okay, now let's get to this bold letters paragraph. However, reversal mechanism shall not apply to services provided by a GTA by way of transport of goods in a goods carriage by road to a department or establishment of the central government or state government, union territory or local authority or government agencies which has taken registration under the CGST Act only for the purpose of deducting tax under Section 51 and not for making taxable supply of goods or services. So, simply we can say that the GTA services provided to the government authorities or government agencies which are registered under the GST Act, then reverse charge mechanism shall not apply. Okay, simply we can say a logic also here. The logic is that if reverse charge mechanism is applicable here also, then the government should pay the GST to the GST government only. Okay, are you understanding? Because here the recipient of the GTA services will be the government itself. So the government should pay to the government itself. It's a logic to understand. That is why the reverse charge mechanism here it is not included. Next, coming to the second point, services supplied by an individual advocate including a senior advocate or firm of advocates by way of legal services directly or indirectly. So the second point is discussing about the advocates giving legal services directly or indirectly. That too, it may be individual advocate or an including a senior advocate or firm of advocates. Okay, to whom these services, legal services, are provided? To the business entity any business entity located in the taxable territory. So legal services provided by the advocate or firm of advocates to any business entity located in the taxable territory, then reverse charge mechanism is applicable, and hence the business entity located in the taxable territory shall deposit the tax, that is GST amount, to the government. And the provider of the service, legal services, that is supplier, may be individual advocate including a senior advocate or firm of advocates. Okay, here the legal service meaning is given. The legal service means any service provided in relation to advice, consultancy or assistance in any branch of law in any manner, and includes representational services before any court, tribunal or authority. Simply say, whatever the lawyers do, that is the legal services. Okay, next, coming to the third one, services supplied by an arbitral tribunal to a business entity. So what is arbitral tribunal? It is also a court. It is like a court, but it happens outside the court. Here arbiters are convened a court like atmosphere, and they will be giving resolutions to a problem. That is, its main function is also like a court. What courts do, the arbitral tribunal also do the same. Okay, so the services supplied by an arbitral tribunal to a business entity. An arbitral tribunal is the supplier of the service, but The recipient of the service is any business entity located in taxable territory, and hence the business entity will be pay the business entity which is receiving the service shall be depositing the GST amount to the government. Next, coming to the fourth, services provided by way of sponsorship to any body, corporate or partnership firm. So this sponsorship can be supplied by, that is, can be given by any person to any body, corporate or partnership firm. So the body, corporate or the partnership firm located in the taxable territory shall be paying the GST amount under the reverse charge mechanism. Services supplied by the central government, state government, union territory or local authority to a business entity, excluding renting of immovable property, and services supplied specified below. Services by Department of Post by way of speed post, express parcel post, life insurance and agency services provided to a person other than central government, state government or union territory or local authority. Services in relation to an aircraft or a vessel inside or outside the presence of a port or a airport, transport of goods or services. So in the fifth point, they have mentioned about that the supplier of the service is the central government, state government, union territory or local authority, but the recipient of the service is to a business entity. But the services also exclude, that means the points 1, 2, 3 here, the points 1, renting of immovable property, and 2, services by Department of Post, services in relation to aircraft or vessel inside or outside the presence of a port, transport of goods or passengers. These mentioned services in point number sub point 1 and 2 in the point 5 are taxed as per the forward charge, that is in normal cases, that means reverse charge mechanism will not be applicable for the sub points 1 and 2. Okay, so here also the recipient of the services are business entity located in the taxable territory, so hence business entities will be paying the tax. 5A, services supplied by central government, state government, union territory or local authority by way of renting of immovable property to a person registered under CGST Act. So here if you observe in the fifth point, main point, they have mentioned that services supplied by government, central government, to central government or state government or local authority to a business entity excludes renting of immovable property. So renting of immovable property supplied by the central government or the state government or the union territory or local authority to a business entity, reverse charge mechanism will not be applicable. But the same case, the services supplied by central government or state government or local authority by way of renting of immovable property, if this type of service is provided to any registered person under GST, the person who is registered under GST Act, then the reverse charge mechanism will be applicable. Here the recipient of the service of renting of immovable property is registered person under the CGST Act, and the supplier of the service of renting of immovable property is central government, state government or local authority or union territory. Okay, next, coming to 5B and 5C. These 5B and 5C are written in bold letters. That means we have to understand that these are as recent amendments and these are important ones. Coming to 5B, services supplied by any person by way of transfer of development rights, that is TDR or floor space index, including additional FSI for construction of a project by a promoter. So any person, if he we can understand this by an example. Any person, if he has a land, so what he is doing is he is giving the development rights of that land to a construction company, that is the promoter. Okay, so he is transferring the development rights of on that land to the construction company, that is the promoter. So transfer of development rights is a service. This type of service provided by any person, that is supplied by any person to a construction company, that is promoter, then reverse charge mechanism will be applicable. So according to reverse charge mechanism, the promoter, that is the construction company, shall pay the GST amount to the government as per reverse charge mechanism. This service of transfer of development rights can be provided by any person, but the recipient must be a promoter, that is a construction company like ones. Okay, coming to 5C, long term lease of land 30 years or more by any person against consideration in the form of upfront amount called as premium, salami, cost, price, development charges, or by any other name, and or periodic rent for construction of a project by a promoter. So it can be said as continuation to the 5B, but here something it is different. Here they are saying that long term lease of land, here just we are transferring the development rights, but here we are transferring the land, that is not transferring the whole, we are just giving our land for a lease. That means until it gets developed, the land, for this also I will explain with an example. Any person has a land and he given that land to a promoter, that is a construction company or any developers, for lease, but not by transfer of development rights. He has given by lease. So until and unless the construction company or the developers who are there, they will develop the land, the construction company or the promoter shall pay lease to the lease amount, that is rental amount, to that person who is providing that land. So here we are leasing the land for the purpose of development only. Okay, here the supplier of the service could be any person, but the recipient of the service should be promoter, and hence the promoter shall pay the tax, that is the GST amount, to the government. Coming to the sixth point, services supplied by a director of the company or body corporate to the said company or body corporate. There is nothing to explain in this point, just the services provided by the director to his company. The supplier is the director of the company or a body corporate, and the recipient of the supply is the company or the body corporate located in the taxable territory, and hence the company or the body corporate shall pay the tax to the government under reverse charge mechanism. Coming to the seventh point, services supplied by an insurance agent to any person carrying on insurance business. Simply we can say that services supplied by an insurance agent to the insurance company. The supplier of the service is insurance agent, the recipient is the person carrying on insurance business or the insurance company located in the taxable territory, and hence the recipient will pay the tax under RCM. Coming to the eighth point, services supplied by recovery agent. This recovery agents, what they will do is, for a financial company or a banking company or a non-banking financial company, they will lend the money. So people take money or borrow money from them, people or businesses or anyone. So what does the recovery agents do is, they will collect the money which is to be repaid to these banking company or financial company or NBFCs by the people or the business entities. So recovery agents will go to the persons who have borrowed the money and collect the money, and again they will repay the collected amount to those companies. That is their function. So these type of services supplied by recovery agents to banking company or financial institution or NBFCs, the recipient is banking company or financial institution or NBFCs. The supplier of the service is a recovery agent supplier. So, and hence the banking company or financial institution or non-banking financial company located in the taxable territory will pay the tax. Coming to the ninth point, supply of services by an author, music composer or photographer, artist or the like by way of transfer or permitting the use of enjoyment of a copyright covered under section 13(1) subsection A of the Copyright Act relating to original literary, dramatic, musical or artistic works to a publisher, music company, producer or the like. Simply we can say that any music composer, author, photographer, artist or any person giving service by way of permitting the use of enjoyment of a copyright. That means they are if we see a singer singing a song and after that he publishes to he give copyrights to a company like Sony, like other channels, music channels like that. So these type of service provided by music composer, authors, photographer, artist to publishers, music company, producer or the like located in the taxable territory. So the recipient of the service, publisher, music company, producer or the like located in the taxable territory shall pay the tax to the government because they are the recipient of the service. Coming to the 10th point, supply of service by the members of overseeing committee to Reserve Bank of India. So generally, what is overseeing committee? Generally, overseeing committee is the group of persons or it is association like thing which observes the working of the organization or how the things are going. They will be observing things and report to the higher authority or higher body. Okay, supply of services by the members of overseeing committee to Reserve Bank of India. So the supplier of the service is members of overseeing committee constituted by RBI and the recipient of the service is RBI. So RBI shall pay the GST to the government. Coming to the 11th point, services supplied by individual direct selling agents other than a body corporate partnership or limited liability partnership firm to bank or non-banking financial companies. Simply we can say that who are these direct selling agents are salespersons, like individual salespersons. The persons roam here and there to each and every house or each and every public places, and they will be selling or they will be having a tent and they will be advertising and they will be grabbing the people to buy their product. Those are individual selling direct selling agents, and these individual direct selling agents are providing their services to a body corporate to bank or NBFCs. The individual direct selling agents providing their services to bank or non-banking financial companies. So the recipient of the service is bank or non-banking financial company. So they will be paying the GST to the government. And the supplier of the service is individual direct selling agents other than body corporate or partnership or LLP firm. Okay. Coming to the 12th point, service provided by a business facilitator to a banking company. So what is business facilitator? We can understand business facilitator simply as for a company, for a business to take important decisions, for making important decisions of the business, they will be giving some advices. They are the business facilitators. Okay, so services provided by business facilitator to a banking company, then the recipient of the services supplied by business facilitator is a banking company. So the banking company located in the taxable territory shall pay the GST amount to the government, and the supplier of the service is business facilitator. And coming to the 13th point, services provided by an agent of business correspondent to business correspondent. So agent giving service to principal, but the principal is a business correspondent. Okay, so services supplier is agent of the business correspondent, and the recipient is the business correspondent located in the taxable territory. So if you observe in the every point, the recipient should be in the taxable territory. Okay, for making levy of tax, the person should be in the taxable territory. So that is why in the section 9 also we have mentioned that the person should be present in the taxable territory. If you observe the e-commerce operator point, the e-commerce operators shall appoint a specific person for just paying the tax. Okay, that is why the recipient of the service should be located in the taxable territory. Okay, so in the 13th case, the supplier is agent of business correspondent and the recipient is a business correspondent located in the taxable territory. So the business correspondent will pay the tax, obviously. Coming to the 14th point, security services provided by way of supply of security personnel provided to a registered person. However, nothing contained in this entry shall apply to a department or establishment of the central government or state government or union territory or local authority or government agencies which has taken registration under the CGST Act only for the purpose of deducting tax under section 51 of the said act, and not for making any taxable supply of goods or services, a registered person paying tax under the commons composition scheme. So any person, but he should not be a body corporate. So any person supplying the security personnel, that means security services, like security we will be finding for businesses, they shall be providing security, like security people. Okay, so that kind of services shall not apply to the government. That means reverse charge mechanism in this type of supply of service, if it is made to a government, okay, or a registered person paying tax under composition scheme, this we will be understanding in the next class, that is section 10 of CGST Act. Okay, what is composition scheme? So the security services provided by any person to the government or any registered person paying tax under the common composition scheme as per section 10 of the CGST Act, then reverse charge mechanism shall not be applied. And also, as per reverse charge mechanism basis, if we see the supplier of the service here is any person other than body corporate, we should be careful. And this second thing is, the recipient of the service is a registered person located in the taxable person. A registered person located in the taxable territory. Here, the registered person means the registered person under GST Act, but not registered person as per income tax or registered person as per the Companies Act or any other act. But here we are discussing about the GST Act. So a registered person means a registered person under GST Act. That means a person got registered under the GST shall be liable to pay tax for these kind of services receiving. Okay, this is the brief, I mean deep explanation of reverse charge mechanism, what kind of specific supply of goods and services are to be considered under the reverse charge mechanism. So this is the table which shows specific kind of services when supplied to specific persons, then the recipient shall be liable to pay the tax to the government. And in the first point we have discussed about the supplier of the service who has not paid CGST at 6%. So we shall be discussing this now. Here is the flowchart. So we will be explaining this as per this flowchart. So person liable to pay tax under GTA service, there are two rates, that is where GST is payable at 5%, where GST is payable at 12%. So firstly we will discuss where GST is payable at 5%. Recipient is the one who is the specified recipients. That means in the first point of reverse charge mechanism, specific services, we have discussed that specified recipients as the factory registered under factory persons, factories act, cooperative society, and etc. Then the tax shall be liable, the tax to be paid as per reverse charge. Okay, the person who is receiving the GTA service. Okay, and what if the person who is not as per the specified recipients, if the person is not as per the specified recipients, then exempt from GST. Here it is mentioned, exempt from GST. Coming to where GST is payable at 12%, that means CGST, SGST divided as 6% and 6% equally. Recipient is one of the specified recipients. If he is the as per specified recipients, then the person liable to pay GST is GTA, that is the goods transport agency only, as per forward charge. Okay, if not as per specified recipients, then shall exempt from GST. So what we have to understand is either the GTA service is payable at in the case of GTA services supplied, whether GST is payable as per 5% or 12%. Firstly we have to check, if it is 12%, then we have to check that the person who is receiving the service is as per specified recipients, then the GTA service provider, that is the goods transport agency, will only be liable to pay the GST. When it comes to the other side, that is where GST is payable at 5%, then the recipient is as per the specified recipients, then the recipient of the GTA service, that is the person as per specified recipients, shall pay the tax. If in the both cases the person is not as per the specified recipients, then shall be considered as exempt from GST. So this is reverse charge mechanism, and in the next class we shall be discussing about the composition levy, that is section 10 of the CGST Act. it is very important to understand the composition scheme. I hope you all like the video. So please do like, share, comment and subscribe. For any queries, contact the mobile number mentioned in the description. Thank you.